kind of instrument issued by the company. Acknowledging it, suppose the companies, if the companies, they want to get some loan from the public. So after getting the loan, the companies has to give one receipt to them. Whatever the receipt they are giving, that receipt is simply called as debenture. That means suppose, say this is there. You can say this one also just like as a debenture. Then what are the contents included and what about the material matter they want to show on the debenture? Here on debenture, generally name of the company they want to write. From whom they are getting the money? Suppose, say from Ravi, they are getting the money from Ravi. How much amount? Suppose 5 lakhs. Then what about rate of interest? Suppose 10% rate of interest. Now whether the debentures are secured or not, then the debentures are secured. What about redemption period? That means after completion of how many years the company wants to repay the amount to the debenture holder? Suppose 20 years. Like this. That means the information regarding the debentures is purely clearly mentioned on a separate document which is called as a debenture. That means this is an instrument acknowledging by the company that the company had taken a loan from the public. Here, the important thing is interest. One is interest and the second one is redemption, nothing but principal value. So after completion of how many years the company wants to redeem the debentures? The company wants to pay the redeem means pay. The company wants to redeem the debentures at what rate of interest? Here the important point of this one is rate of interest is predetermined rate of interest. Suppose in the year 2020, means in the current year, the rate of interest is suppose fixed rate 14%. This is consistent. The time period of the debenture say 20 years. That means since all these 20 years, the debenture holder will get 14% interest on his debenture amount. That is the very reason why it is required to show the rate of interest as a prefix to the debentures. This is the simple meaning of a debenture. Then what about generally in normal language? Features, yeah. This is features of a debenture. What are the features of a debenture? It is a retained instrument. Acknowledging by the company. This is the first point. Then the second point, it is repayment schedule. Repayment means after completion of how many years the company wants to repay the amount to the debenture holders. Whether it is 10 years or whether it is 20 years or whether it is 30 years, like that. Then the next one, it is secured. Generally, all the debentures are secured only. Of course, if you want to go through the different types of debentures, no, you will have different types of debentures. But among all, the best debenture it is secured debenture. That means if the company fails to make the payment to the debenture holders, always they are secured, always they are safe, because the company, they will get the money from the company, which is called as secure. Generally, the debenture amount always is called as long-term sources only. Long-term source. In my previous example also, the debenture period I mentioned as 20 years. Generally, the sources also, short-term sources, then medium-term sources, then long-term sources. Short-term sources means 1 month to 4 months, means less than 1 year. Then medium term is 1 to 5 days and long term is more than 5 days. So as I mentioned, it is 20 years, so that it is called as long term financial sources only. Then whatever the interest the companies they are paying, this is for acknowledgement, this is a very, very important point. Whatever the interest they are paying on the debentures amount, that is always interest charged against profits. That means whether they are having profits or not, whether the profits are sufficient or not. First of all, the companies, they have to make the payment to the debenture holders in the name of interest, that is compulsory. And one more feature of debenture, it is redeemable. the redeemable debentures only. Redeemable debentures means the debenture holders, they are going to get their money after completion of certain period, stipulated period. That is called as redeemable. That means payable. That means after completion of stipulated period, the company ready to pay the amount to the debenture holders. So that only debenture holders always they are treated as a creditors to the company. Whatever the amount they are getting in the name of debenture, generally some companies that amount they are calling as loan capital, because that is also just like they want to show as a capital, but it is not the permanent capital, it is a loan capital only. That is, it is a temporary capital only. Now, this is one more thing: debentures and bonds. Actually, in company's language, this is securities. I think you might have used this word. Securities, here in securities you will find three terms. One is shares, and second one is debentures, and third one is bonds. Already you know the meaning of shares. Now, I explained this debentures also, the meaning of debenture. Now it is bonds. What is the main difference between debentures and bonds is, in case of debentures, the rate of interest is very important. In case of debentures, the rate of interest is predetermined. That means, really in advance only the company wants to disclose the rate of interest to the debenture holders. But whereas, in case of bonds, the rate of interest is not at all pre-decided. So that is the whole big difference between debentures and bonds. Then the remaining aspects, they won't find any kind of difference between different bonds, debentures and bonds, excluding interest factor. So that only generally, this is also called as zero coupon bonds. Sometimes the company don't want to make the payment of interest to the debenture holders. Suppose the bond value is say 10 lakhs. This is bond value. Now the company wants to issue the same bond to the holders, suppose at 6 lakhs only. That means now the company is getting 6 lakhs only by issuing the bonds to the public. But at the time of redemption, the company has to pay 10 lakhs rupees. That means, what is the benefit of the purchaser?